What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to create this cool stair railing. It's this type of a railing that goes from your stair and then all the way up to the ceiling. It doesn't have like a fixed height. I think it's really cool for interior design. It makes your interiors look just much cooler than they would if you had regular railing, and it's something that can be really difficult to achieve, but I found a workaround, a little trick where you can actually achieve this quite easily and simply, so I'm going to be showing you that, as well as a few extra tips and tricks on how to improve your stair and railing design. Now, I'm doing this for a couple of reasons. The first one is obviously it looks really cool, so why not share how to do something like this in Revit? And the second one is, of course, to promote one of my Revit courses. I have a whole entire course on stairs and railings in Revit. It's available on my website, balkanarchitect.com. It's going to be the first link just below this video and also up in the cards, so make sure to check it out if you're interested. There I have multiple Revit courses on different Revit topics. Also, one more thing before we start with the video, make sure to like this video and make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell icon, not only because it helps you not miss any of my future videos, but more importantly, it makes the alpaca happy, and well, that's why we're all here. Okay, so without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see here, I am at the home screen of Revit. Now I'm just going to go here straight to models and then to new. Now here, as you can see, I have a couple of my custom templates. You can check those out on my website as well. I have these kind of ready to go templates, so if you're interested, check those out. Again, it's going to be linked just below the video and also up in the cards. In this particular case, let's just go with the default metric template. So if you want to follow along right now, you can do that easily because, well, you already have this one. So anyways, here we are finally in Revit, and I'm just going to go and create a simple floor here. So let's create just a small floor segment like that. Hit finish. Then I'm going to add a wall on this side. So for that, let's go to the wall tool. WA is the shortcut. And for the wall type, I'm just going to go with the generic 300 millimeter type. And then here for the location line, I'm just going to be using finish face exterior and just go like this. Now, if it's going on the wrong side, like mine is, just hit the space key to kind of flip it towards the inside. Hit the escape key a couple of times. There we go. Next, now I want to create the actual stair. So for that, I'm going to go to the circulation panel, the stair tool. And then here on the stair tool, it's just going to be a simple run. Now in the properties, make sure to set this as a monolithic stair because that's what I want to create. For the actual run width, let's go with 120 or 1200 millimeters. And yeah, then let's just create the stair, which, well, goes like this. Now for this stair, I'm going to kind of snap it toward to that wall and then perhaps center it a little bit, perhaps like that. There we go. Perfect. Now here you have the option to go to railing, and then you have the option to choose which railing you want to go with. Now in this case, I'm just going to be going with the default railing, and just make sure that the position is set on treads and not the stringers, because, well, in this case, this is a monolithic stair and we don't even have stringers. But even if we did, I think this looks a bit better when it's set on treads. So click OK, then hit finish. And there we go, we have our stair. Let's go to the 3D view, and this is what that looks in the 3D view. Now obviously we need the floor up here, so I'm just going to select this floor, and then let's go to the clipboard panel, go to the copy to clipboard, copy, paste, align to selected levels, and then here I'm just going to choose the level 2. Click OK, and it's going to appear there. Then we can go into edit boundary, and first I want to place the boundary kind of on the inside edge. Then I want to use the pick lines, pick the front kind of face of the stair, the one in the back, and then one of these sides, and it's just going to appear all over here. See how it does? So we have this one, and then this one. And I can just use the trim and extend to just connect these two, then go to split element, split this, trim and extend, and you can fix it all up. Perfect. Now we have something that looks exactly how it should. We just hit finish, and then this was what we're left with. Perhaps change this to a 300 millimeter type, just so it's a little bit thicker. I think it looks a bit nicer. There we go. And then one thing that I'm going to be changing with this is just going here and going into edit boundary, and then I'm going to switch back here to level 1, zoom in, and I'm just going to move this towards the kind of inside edge of that railing. So I've just picked this inside edge of the railing. That's what I want to align to. So once I've done that and then I hit finish, see now how railing kind of goes through that floor. That's exactly what we want to see. And now what I'm going to do is just select, I'm going to select this railing and change it. So let's make it, I don't know, let's make it a pipe and just leave it for now. And for this one, I'm going to select it, go to edit path. And now for this path, what you want to do is go to your level 2 floor plan, zoom in, and then you want to move that path up to this step here. So it kind of stops with this step, or you can actually even go to this step in this case, just because it's a small gap there. There we go, just like that. And then what you want to do is just make sure to select that path for your railing. And then here we have the slope option, and I'm just going to change it from host to flat. And then I'm going to hit finish. And now, as you can see, it's just going to be flat, and it looks like this. It looks kind of terrible. So there are some things that we need to change with this railing. So what I want to do now is just kind of select that railing, go into edit type. Now, in this case, you can just use the type that you have, or you can create a new type. So you can go to duplicate and then create a new type. If you have like a big project, important project, I would use duplicate. In this case, I'm just going to skip that step because I don't really care. So let's go then to this top rail, and currently the type is this rectangular 50 by 50. I'm just going to open that up. Then I'm just going to go here to the profile, and I'm going to expand that, and let's use the square 20 millimeter profile. Hit apply. Okay. And there we go. So now, as you can see, the profile here is much smaller, and that's exactly what they wanted to achieve. And the next step is just to move this railing all the way to the ceiling. So we can do that simply by going here to the height, and then I'm just going to go here to the height parameter and just change it. So let's try 1500 millimeters. So if I hit apply, as you can see, it goes up. Then let's try something else. Let's try 1600 millimeters, hit apply. It's almost there. Let's try 1800, hit OK, and then zoom in. There we go. Everything now looks perfect. So now we have that railing exactly how it should look. Now, obviously, we can kind of fine tune it a little bit. I don't like the fact that it kind of starts with these two that are very narrowly kind of together. So you can select that railing, and then you can go here into edit type. Then you can go to your baluster placement, and then here for the baluster placement, you can go to the posts and just change them all to none. So I just go here and change them to none, 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 and hit apply, okay, apply, okay, and as you can see now, that is gone. And now on the other side, we have this railing that, well, it's not necessary, so we can delete it, but if we did delete that, it would give us an issue. We really wouldn't have any handrail. We wouldn't have anything to kind of grab on as you're climbing up the stairs, which is kind of useful to have. So I'm just going to select this railing, and I'm going to convert that into just a wall-hosted handrail. So this is kind of a cool kind of little side project for this video. So I'm just going to select that, go here into edit type, and again, it's the same story. It would make sense to duplicate this on an important project. This is just a demonstration, so I'm just going to leave it as is. I'm going to go to the rail structure, select the first one, and then just delete everything. And apply, okay. Then let's go to the baluster placement, and we don't need any. So again, none, 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 and none. Okay. Apply, okay, apply, and as you can see, everything is gone apart from that top rail. Now, we don't really need the top rail. What we want is the handrail. So you go here to handrail 1, you go and then you set it well, it appears over here, it kind of opens up. So here you have that handrail. You can customize it if you want. I'm just going to click OK. So it's going to be this pipe wall mounted. And then you go to the position, and in this case, this wall is on the right. So the position of the handrail is on the left of the wall. I hope that makes sense. Hit apply. And as you can see, that handrail will appear over here. Now the top rail doesn't really make any sense here. So I can just uncheck that, hit apply. Okay. And there we go. We have that handrail. Now it's kind of floating in the air like this. And that's only because we have that offset from path that's just by default when you place your railing on your treads. So you can just select that railing, go here to offset from path and just type in 0. And there we go. I think we've finished this there. So we have that nice little kind of interior railing element. On the other side, we have the handrail, so everything's still quite functional, working really well. And in the end, it's a fun little project, and I think the results look really, really good. Okay, so that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you want this project file, as well as the rest of my Revit project files, it is available on my Patreon page, which is going to be just the first link just below this video, and also I'm going to link it up in the cards, so make sure to check it out. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.